Well, you know, some people like to change their shoes to match their outfits, and other people like to paint their nails to match their outfits, and I like to change my earrings. And I do a lot of paper crafting, and I thought, I wonder if I could use my paper craft supplies to make earrings. And I found this cool box of stuff at Goodwill, and I decided to try. So this was the first earring that I made, and I'm going to show you how to make it. I'm going to use one of these label holders, and you see it's got holes at both ends. So we're just going to take a pair of wire cutters, and just mine aren't strong enough, so I just have to kind of wiggle them back and forth and back and forth until the end breaks off. So then the next step is to cut a piece of paper, any kind of paper that you like the design of, to fit the size of your label. And of course you could measure it, or you could just do the cut and snip. And I'm using the same paper, but I'm purposely not taking the same section of it, because I want them to be a little bit different. And I want it to be shorter than the label holder, because I'm going to be putting a hole in it, and you'll see. So then what I'm going to do is use my best glue ever, shake it into the tip, and then just run a bead of glue around the outside of this. Okay, and then I'm going to punch a hole in the bottom of this metal, and I've got this handy dandy little hole punch thing, and it's a good idea to mark where you want to punch the hole, because it's hard to see it in once it goes inside of here. So when you've got it lined up with your little dot, and you just keep turning until it becomes hard to turn, and then all of a sudden it'll become easy when it gets through. That's it. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to make these little dangly beads. So, way back in the late 90s, I remember wire was the thing for scrapbooking, and I had to have all of these colors of wire. So I'm going to use my Papercraft wire, and I need to cut 3 pieces of wire. And I have this kind of piece of steel. If you don't have something like this, you'll need to find something heavy to pound on, even maybe perhaps 2 hammers, I don't know. So what you're going to do is take your hammer, and this is another Papercraft tool that was for setting eyelets, and all I'm going to do is just hammer the end of this wire. And then I'm going to take a few, thread them onto the wire, And because we made that flattened thing on the end, it stops the bead. Okay. And then what we're going to do is put it through and bend it around, and then we're just going to wrap this wire around the other wire. And it could be helpful to hold this little loop with a pair of pliers. And then just wrap. And then we're just going to take the wire cutters and snip the little tail off as close as you can to the end. So if there's a little sharp part hanging out, just take a pair of pliers and hold the loop. And then with another pair of pliers, then just squish the end in. Okay, so we've got our first little dangle. And we'll do that again. It gets a little bit more complicated as you add them because it's more cluttered. So we've got two dangles. And let's go for the third. And then just take your wire and start wrapping. Get those little guys out of the way. Like I said, by the third one, it's getting a little crowded in here. It's probably what triplets feel like. Okay, take our little snips. And then hold a little loop. Okay, so the next step is we're going to put glossy accents on the paper. Not only will it make it shiny, but it'll also preserve it for moisture. So my glossy accents is pretty old, and it was very, very thick. So I just added some water to it. You have to, if you do that, and you shake it up to mix it, it will get bubbles in it, so you'll need to let it sit for a while. But because it is a water base, you can thin it with water. And then I have a No-Clog writing cap on from Scrap Perfect, which is just a brilliant thing because my glossy accents always clogged, and so now it doesn't anymore, and it's very easy to put it exactly where I want it to be. So and then I'll just put the cap back on. Next time it won't be clogged, and we'll let it dry. It starts out kind of cloudy and bluish, and then when it dries, it'll turn clear. It's dry, so now we're going to put some glossy accents on the back, and the only caution I have is to make sure that you don't get it where the wire is, because then they won't jangle nicely. and we'll let it dry to clear. So here's the finished earring. Well, except for the ear wire. And there's the pair. So they're made from Papercraft supplies.